Hi there, welcome. This is Ted here from eModels.co.uk. This is part one of the video build of the Deutsche Kriegsmarine U-Boat Type 7C U552 in a huge 1/48 scale. In this episode, with a fanfare of trumpets, we're going to cut the first part and glue the first parts of this amazing build together. Let's get it done and see you in a moment. Welcome back. Welcome. This is a very special moment. I should perhaps make speeches and pass around champagne to the assembled guests present. However, we'll just get on with the build. We'll cut open the bag, cut the first piece of plastic, and begin this amazing build. Okay, we slide the first sprue out of the bag. It's sprue F, and we're looking at the instructions, blinding the camera with the white balance. And we look, and to begin with, we begin at part one. This is a construction of a torpedo, and there's 12 of them. However, we'll just look at this, getting this one done, and then we can move on. So here goes, let's have a look. We need two parts for one torpedo, Z3 and Z11. And using clippers, get them off. And nice and clean, there's a few nubs on there, so we find a sanding stick and just denub. On one side done, nearly that. All right, let's see how it goes together. Locating pins and locating holes, and needs a little bit more off, just a bit I think, just to get that smooth and go on to a finer stick. Still a bit. I think we could just take that off. That's got it there, I think. And the same one, it seems the nubs are in the same place on the moulding, so they'll work against each other if you get them a little bit out. Right, that's gone together a little bit better now, so we can, it's just a little gap in there, but I think we can make that up when we glue, and certainly make it up when we fill, because the seam lines are obviously going to need filing down on this. Next part looks like the propellers on part Z. Now, where are we at again? Oh, this isn't part F, it's part Z, sprue Z. There we are. Propellers are down here. There's two of them, counteracting propellers. I believe that's to stop the torpedo spinning in the water. It would have a fin on it, but this would make it run straight and true. I'll be just off shot a minute, because there's a couple of little nubs just on the fins that just need to be taken off. It would seem that these prop blades, see that coming to focus? There we go, coming to focus. These prop blades are fairly fragile, so just take a bit of care filing them off. Just cutting off, smoothing off the excess plastic where it's been attached to the sprue. Same on this one. Now here, I'm still here. There we go, I'm back again. Not much work, there doesn't seem to be much of a mould line on these, so there's really no work to do on them. And then they go on one on top of the other. There's a little locating pin on one and a hole on the other, and they go in, and if you look at them, they are conical, so it creates just a large cone. That will go in there if we can find our glue. Just a touch of that and some tweezers to drop that one on there. Now when you position these on, just don't line the props up, but twist them just so that they're indisposed, just so that one blade's between the other, so they look a little bit like that. It's a bit difficult showing you this in this scale after I've been working on such large scales for a while. The 1/16 scale, it's much easier to see on camera. I have to bear that in mind, that you may not see things as easily as you've been seeing on the builds I've done in the past. That's that one. Give that a few minutes to dry, we'll put that to one side. What do we need now? Back to the plan. Is these blades, sort of a fin, Z2 and Z10. Always try to leave a little bit on when cutting from the sprue and trim it back rather than cutting flush up to it, and just trim it and file it back. I'm just off shot again, just trimming these up on the edge of the cutting mat. It saves any pressure on the part itself by cutting. Let's get a cutting mat in, and without knocking the camera, what I do is just place the part. Let's try to stop the camera wobbling. Just place the part on the edge of the cutting mat and just slice it down. Same on that. This one. That there, flick it across there. Right, and what do we do now? We look, it looks like we make that assembly up to become that part there. So I'll bring there. Right, that's that bit glued. The propeller. Nice, like that. Now that would seem, just try this to fit in there. Does it go that way around? No, the other way around. Like that, and then that piece, problem, goes in there. Or doesn't, as the case may be, because it's too big. Bit of a fiddle, let's try another way. Z10, that goes in there like that. Work, work. Don't want to work today. No. There. See, it sits in there like that. Then this one seemed to work its way. I think the best way to do this is to put that there. This has all got to go over here without knocking that off, and then we can glue it all together at the same time. Hopefully fiddly bits, fiddly 1/48 scale, it's not as good, it's not as easy as 1/16. The pieces are so tiny. I better spend far more time scrabbling about looking for parts than I have on the other kits. Well, good job we didn't glue anything in first. Let's have a go. There we go. You can eventually work that through the propellers and it will come in to position like that. And then that piece, I haven't glued these together yet, but that piece will then glue. I can see a problem, well, not a problem. I can see an issue here. Right, what I would suggest, instead of gluing this in a section like that, instead of gluing it all together first, I would assemble it, dry assemble it, glue this, and then put all that together. So the torpedo itself is glued, and then when it slides together like that, it will line up. Because otherwise, if you get these misaligned like that or anything, it may not go in there together easily. So right, first cut of the first video, and now we're going to have the first cut of the first scene. So I'll go and glue these together, let the glue go off, and we'll come back and have a look at it in a moment. See you in a moment. Okay, welcome back. You join me as I've let the glue dry on this torpedo, and I'm now just filing down the seam lines. One way of doing attending to the seam lines is obviously, as you know, is just give it a bit more glue than you would normally, and then squeeze. squeeze until a thin bead of plastic pops out all along, and then with a few clamps, clamp it tight, let it set, and then you can go over and just rub the seam lines down without adding too much filler. It does look as though maybe I need just a very light thin skim of some filler. I'll probably give them a coat of primer first, just to maybe check out what's needed and where, and then fettle them all up with that. Just take care when you are filing the seams down, because of the short the small vein on the front. Why is this camera not focusing today? The short vein just on the front of the torpedo, very fragile. I think that is part of the clockwork mechanism that spins as the torpedo goes through the water and activates the detonator inside. I think these are contact torpedoes, not proximity torpedoes. The U-boat stroke torpedo experts out there might be able to keep us informed. Let us know on the notes below. All information is useful as I go along this build. So that's that. As you can see, the rear vanes have settled in. Trying to keep it in focus now. I'm just getting used to building small things again. The rear vanes have gone in, the propellers have gone in. They'll be painted in brass. Which sort of brass and what product I'm going to use has yet to be decided, but I will give them a coat of black primer first and do them up that way. Right, that's that done. So there we are, there's the first part of the U-boat build. It's a model, yeah, I suppose it's a model in a model which makes a model. Your model is built up of lots of other models, and this is going to be one lot of models. Right, let's have a look at the next bit. Right, we're going from here, we're going to have a look at the forward torpedo tube compartment. Let's have a look. Right, we'll bring the Z sprue back, and we need these bits off there. There's an upside and a downside. I tend to think that these may be bunks. A submarine tends to be a fighting machine built for the purpose of carrying weapons, and the crew are secondary to its requirements. So space, facilities and everything else, particularly during the war, was secondary to everything else. These were just a way of carrying weapons to destroy the enemy. So sleeping wherever and whenever they could. We'll just trim some of these nubs off, some of the obvious ones. So we now need to go and cut another part open, another bag open, which is part G, which seems nicely bubble wrapped. Ooh, we can play with that after. Spend hours relaxing, popping bubble wrap. Right, let's get that out of the way. There's the part we need. Don't know what that is. It's fallen off there, I think. Back in the bag. Keep everything in the bag. Keep the bags. Keep everything in the bags as long as you can. I should really practice what I preach, but there we go. So that comes off there. That comes off there. Oh, I've just noticed we make two of these. So I'll cut the other one out after. Cut that. That. Try to work out what it is, not quite obvious just yet. Let's have a look in the colour album. Which way does it go? Front torpedo tube compartment, there we are. Yes, as I thought, these are bunks. We're also going to add some of the equipment in here now. There and there. And according to this, we're going to need some decals. So obviously before that, I think we need to paint. Right, let's get it together first and we'll have a look. So. Nubs again. Oh, we need to go back to part G. Where did I put it? It back in the bag, obviously. Oh yeah, I can't see if we're looking on the same sprue. You know how many times you put things down there in front of you and then you can't find it. That one. Now there we'll build into there. These are textured on one side. And I think they're there to give the impression of mattresses. Yeah, possibly. We'll go in there like that. That like that. And then 1, 2, 3. On there. Now there wasn't enough bunks for all the crew, so they had a system of what was called hot bunking. Those that were off watch got into bed and slept. Those that were on watch or at work did the job, and then when everybody swapped over, the guys got out of bed and swapped beds. So you were always getting into a hot bunk. That process continued until quite recently. I can't remember the dates, but certainly within my lifetime, there were hot bunking on submarines. And still sleeping in hammocks in the 60s. There, right. I've got that to build. I've got this little bit of equipment to find and put on as well. I've got another one of these to make, so I'll go and get that done. And then we can look at the next bit, which is the first part of putting it all together, or putting one of the compartments together. And it looks like lots of little bits in here. We'll get the bits out, we'll have a look at them and decide what we're going to do. Okay, see you in a moment. Alright, welcome back. Now that my assembled guests have departed, I'll get on with the build and show you what to do next. Just a quick note before we move on to the next section as such. What I've found when I've put this together, I was thinking that if I put it together and started spraying everything and trying to paint everything up now, I probably wouldn't do a very good job of getting into these bunks. So I've only dry fit them together, and then what I'll do, I'll at least prime it, prime the bunks, maybe put some colour in the bunks as well, because we're not going to get in to do the lower bunks properly with a paintbrush and paint it properly without getting paint everywhere and masking and things like that. So I'm going to leave it apart, spray it, and then paint it. And looking at the instructions, although it tells us to build this part, there is quite a bit to do building torpedo tubes, building the watertight bulkhead between the torpedo room. There's quite a bit to do before we see this piece again. There it is, section 15. So we don't really need it just yet. There's a lot more to do, and there's some paint and building to go on. So we could probably move on to the next stage. Alright, I just thought I'd come back and mention that, and see you in a moment. Okay everybody, welcome back. Some of the observant amongst you will have noticed that since the other part of the video, we've gone for a change of angle. Since the last segment of the video was recorded, Christmas has been and gone, and have received a visit from Santa, and he's provided me with a new video camera. In fact, I've got two of them. I've got one here and one over there, which will give a wider aspect of the workbench. Also, I've got another microphone, so hopefully we'll be able to see a increase in the quality of the video and the sound. And also, I've taken to mounting this one in a different position, so no more wobbly cams, hopefully. Anyway, back onto the build. When we left the last bit, we were looking at parts of the torpedo room, and one of the important parts of the torpedo room is this. It's a torpedo. Now then, I've had a look around the internet and trying to find out the proper colours of these torpedoes, and the best I could find, or the sort of consistency I could find, was that they had a metallic body with a different coloured head, most often in bronze. Some were coloured for various reasons, but I think I'll go the metallic body and bronze head. So we can get on with this. Now, what we've done, we saw them going apart, going together in the first part of the video, and this is the next stage. So what I've done, I've gone and give it a coat of Ultimate Products Black Primer. Brilliant stuff. It goes on easily, fairly idiot proof, goes on with the airbrush, flattens down straight away, and gives a good hard finish. We need black for the product that we're going to use, because we're going to use some of the AK Interactive True Metals. I've got this one, which is old bronze. I've got this one, which is brass, Some of you who have been following may have seen me use this in the Panzer build, and this one is steel. How do we apply it? Well, it goes on fairly easily. It can be quite messy, but I've found a nice easy way to do this is to give it a application with a brush. Now, I find the right one. We'll use this metal. Apply it straight from the tube. No need to squeeze it out anywhere. I find that just a nice thin paintbrush and just paint it on. Paint it on not too thick, but paint it on. In fact, I think I've got a too small a brush here. Right, put that to one side. Bigger brush. This is a number 7 brush, 7 round brush. Once again from the tube. And there we go, that's a bit better. You can apply this with a cotton bud. Some people say that actually thinned properly with some thinners you can actually spray it, but I've never actually done that. I find it goes on as easy as this. Right, let me go on and get this coated and I'll show you the next stage. Alright, here we go. Okay, that's that one done. I'm just going to leave it now for about half an hour, just to let it's a wax paste this, so we're just going to let the wax harden, and then we'll come back and have a look at the next stage of it. But in the meantime, I'll go on and I'll do exactly the same and give the warhead a coat of the antique bronze. Right, so see you in a moment. Well, half an hour, but see you in a moment. Okay there, welcome back. It's been about a little over half an hour for me, just a matter of seconds for you. That's it. I've gone on, it's a bit difficult to catch it just in the light here because of the reflection. There, a little bit. You see what's happened now is that we've got both the warhead and the body covered in the true metal, and it's left it with a sort of a flat shine. So all we need to do to it now is just give it a polish, and I've got one of these microfiber cloths, and obviously I've chose a white one that will play havoc with the white balance, but we can get on and live with that. And all we do is just rub it gently, not much. The polish is going hard, and what you're really doing is ticking all the sort of irregularities out, all the brush marks and things like that. The unevenness, and it actually produces a very nice, very realistic shine. See if we can do the top there, and in a good old Blue Peter fashion, here's one I did earlier, and I can quite make out the difference. I know I've polished this one a little bit there, but that one here is a little, this one here, see how it's a little bit flatter, just how I haven't polished it up yet. Just trying to get it in shot there for you. See on the warheads, there's a difference. Hopefully you can see the difference in this shot. Just trying to catch it so the light doesn't reflect on it. That's the problem with metallics,
light is going to, you can see quite well there how that polishes up there. There's still the stabilizer fins just to paint up yet. Those, from what I can gather, they weren't actually the same steel. They're probably just a steel rudder, and they're just painted. And I'll just do them in a mid grey, almost the sort of same cut. This is a Humbrol 127, the same as the torpedo, the tube itself, the missile itself, and the propellers on this one coming up here a little bit. There you can see I've done them in brass, the same brass, the same true metal but in brass. Once you get that on, you can actually paint them, but I've just got that out of hand, so I tried it, but it's a little bit too far to get in there. Just to, you can probably try and brush it up with a small brush. Yeah, that'll do. So that there is a pretty good realistic looking torpedo, or it will be when I paint this end. Realistic looking torpedo. The trigger mechanism at the end, I'm not sure on that. I think I'll do that in a brass as well. Just then it would give a little bit of a definition, a difference between the old bronze and the brass trigger on the end. I understand what that does is actually screws out as this goes through the water. That spins and screws out and arms the warhead inside. And kaboom. Anyway, that's that bit done. I'm going to go on and do the rest of these. Now then, it does say that there are 15 of them. I think I mentioned this before, that there's 15 of them, but five of them, it says in the plan in the book, five of them are in torpedo tubes. There, just see the end of that one in there. Builds them in, you build them into the torpedo tubes, never to be seen again. So I did a lot of that on the Panzer IV build, and I don't think I'm really going to do it again this time, so I can't see them being much point in building 15 torpedoes that half we're never going to see. Right, so I'll go and have a look at the next bit, torpedo tubes themselves. And then we'll come back and have a bit of a roundup for this video. There's not really a lot to do in this video. It's just sort of getting everything together, getting everything started and pulling all the bits in. Finding the right paints. Finding the right paints for the interior has been sort of a bit of a trick, because Trumpeter say that the interior is in 335, which is medium sea grey. Now I'm really thinking that is perhaps a little bit too dark for the interior of the submarine. I've worked on submarines myself, build them, or have built, been part of the team that builds them here in the town where I live in the UK. I've never seen a great interior of a submarine yet. They're saying that the torpedo tubes H18, where's that one at? Can't actually find it on here. H18 metal black, yeah, so they're the blacks around there, sorry, just around the torpedo doors. But they're saying that the colour of the torpedo tube should be 338, which is dark sea, medium sea grey. 338, light grey. I actually don't think so. Once again, looking around the internet, most everything I've seen has been white. So I'll be doing it a mixture of greys and whites, flat whites, grey whites, and things like that. Right. Torpedo tubes. Let's go on and build a torpedo tube. So I'll go and get the bits, finish these off. I've gone out of focus a bit. Right, see you in a moment. Oh, hi, welcome back. Yeah, this is the other view that you'll get with the new camera setup. Bit of a bench, so I can explain things a little bit better perhaps. And it just saves you seeing the hands all the time. What we're going to do now, we're going to get on and build the torpedo tubes. I've already gone on and built the first three. Got the sprues at the back. I've cut the parts off, got them here on the bench. So it's time to come and put them together. So with a bit of a scene change, we come over here to the workbench. And just turn this off a minute. Right, I've cut the parts off. Here's the tube itself. Just the same as building the torpedoes, really. Put them together, put some glue in it, squeeze the joint together and hold it till the glue goes off. And then you can file down the ridge at the top. As I said, I've cut most of the parts off. There's a couple of pieces still to go on at the end. But they don't really need to go on until the whole thing's together. Need to follow the instructions fairly well, because once I find my tweezers, I'll rattle about in the background a moment, because we need some tweezers for this, because some of these parts are fairly small and delicate. Try to get it right here. It does show that some of these parts here are install last, install first. So just make sure you read the instructions and you'll be able to follow it through and get things in the right order. One or two of these bits are fairly delicate, as I've said, and they need a bit of care cutting them from the sprue. And look at your reference in the book just to make sure that you're not cutting off some of the nubs. cutting off the wrong ones. So without further ado, all the parts are here apart from the H sprues, but they'll go together at the end. So I'll get on and glue these together, and then we'll show it all as a complete section at the end. All right, let's get on with it. We'll be right back. Okay then, that's that bit done. Just a little bit of straightening up things to do, because I've just knocked that off. And we'll set that aside to dry. You can see how it's come together now, and the I'm assuming there are pneumatic pipes along the side of the torpedo tubes have sort of really brought it to life. As I say, you just need a pair of tweezers just to straighten some of the pipes up and get them in and get them to hold as you glue them down. They are a bit fragile. Just be careful when you're cutting them off the sprues that you don't snap any. This little piece here, that goes in there. I'll glue that on again in a moment because I forgot that. And you'll see in the book, if I can see it, see how here, just make sure that when you put all the parts in, that you have a look at the completed diagram just to see where everything does go, and then you know you've got it right. So we bring the others in, the three other tubes. I've painted this one's been undercoated, and now they sort of fit together. Which way around do they go? I think they go, yep, with the hinges, the door hinges, to the outside. So they'll go like that. Then these two will fit in, just working out which way they go. No, maybe not that. They go like that. That one thus goes there, I think. I don't want to handle them too much because obviously the glue's still drying on this one. And you'll see, I'm trying to get it at the right angle so when I. So you can see, well, that's how they go anyway. They'll go something like that. So that's the torpedo tubes done. Now we've just got to work on this part here, and then eventually they'll all go together. But what I'll do first, I'll prime them all up and get them ready for painting. Then we can put that all together. Moving on to the next parts. There is some work to do on the torpedo room bulkhead door, on that bulkhead there. There's lots of wheels and cogs and things and everything to go in there, so that's all need to be looked at. I have primed up the other parts. I think this is where the torpedoes will sit. They'll go on there. With another two, another one there. I must say this True Metal, AK Interactive True Metal, it's looking pretty good stuff, and here's one I haven't painted yet. It really does give them a metallic shine. Now I do know that when the crews were installing, loading these into the tubes, they gave them a coat of grease. A greeny, I wouldn't call it an axle grease, but for some reason they give them an extra grease, probably just to make sure that they didn't stick in the tube. I don't know, but that's how they go in there like that. And we can see here how the detail's gone into the torpedo room bridge roof. I'm just keeping this piece on here because there is a very fine, I don't know if you can pick it up, just Oh, for the first time in this video, I think. Pointy stick. Just in there is a very fragile bracket that will hang the torpedo loading bar from. And knowing my luck, if I left it unprotected, it would be knocked off and lost forever. So I'll just, hopefully, try to offer it some protection just by a piece of polystyrene wrap just over that. I'm going to save it all for priming, for base coating, until I've got on with a few more, because you know what it's like, you load your airbrush up and do all the parts, put them away, and then you find some parts that still need painting. So I'll wait a little bit longer till I get everything, a few more pieces done, and then once I finish a compartment, I'll spray them on like that. Anyway, I think for the moment this is going to be the end of this video. Part one of the Trumpeter 148 scale U-boat. We'll catch up a little bit more in the next one, because there's quite a few little bits and pieces in here that and there's a lot of them, and I'm sure that if you are going to sit down and join me right the way through this, you won't want to see me gluing every bit together. I'll do some bits. If there's any issues that I find, I'll bring them up and show you them. Also as well, if you are on the eModels YouTube site, which you must probably be to be watching this video, unless you've found us by chance, go across to the eModels YouTube site and we're going to start and do some live streaming. Catch us live from the bench, your chance to come along and ask some questions, have a look, see what we're doing, have a bit of fun. Sometimes I'll have guests that will come along with me and we'll do some hangout style chats and keep everybody updated as to what's going on. Anyway, that's enough of my rabbiting. I hope you like the new layout at the end of this video, which is a little bit different to where it started. That started on the old camcorder just over here. And we're going to have a look and try and do it now with these new camcorders and the new high-tech sound. So that's me, Ted, from Skipper Scale Models at eModels, eModels.co.uk. So thanks for watching, thanks for looking in, and we'll see you all next time. Bye now.